How's it going, everyone? I'm Theo Joe, and today we're going to take a look at 11 settings in Google Chrome that you should probably change. These may be things you'll want to disable, or cool stuff that's disabled by default that you'll want to enable. Now, I'm using version 63 of Chrome, which is actually the current beta version, so if you're watching this video at a later date, or you're not using the beta version, things may look a little bit different, so don't be surprised at that. I think you'll find these pretty interesting, and also be sure to subscribe for more videos like this, and enable notifications by clicking the bell, or YouTube is not gonna show you my new videos, even if you do subscribe, because look, the YouTube algorithm is a steaming dumpster fire. But anyway, let's get started. So, to start off, we have a feature that last I checked is enabled by default that you probably want to disable. So go to Settings, click Advanced, and then under System, look for the option called Continue Running Background Apps When Google Chrome Is Closed. I don't know about you, but when I close Google Chrome, I expect it to actually close and not have apps keep running in the background I don't know about. I mean, really, what browser apps do I really want to keep running if I'm not even using the browser? So yeah, I would disable that if I were you and probably save some system resources. Okay, number two. This one is also in the settings page, but this time under privacy and security. Look for the setting that says automatically send some system information and page content to Google to help detect dangerous apps and sites. This one is disabled by default, but me personally, I think it's worth it to enable it actually. If you're very privacy conscious, you don't have to obviously, but there are so many malicious websites out there that if more people enable this setting, it'll end up benefiting yourself in the future. Plus, it may make it more likely Chrome will detect a new malicious site you go on even if it hasn't scanned it before. So I think it's worth it. All right, now all of the rest of the settings we're gonna go over are actually in a hidden settings menu called the Chrome Flags menu. Getting there is really simple if you've never seen it before. You just go to the URL bar and type in Chrome:// flags and hit enter. It will warn you that these features are experimental, so it's best to not go randomly enabling and disabling features without knowing what they do. Again, this menu might have a different design based on what version of Chrome you're using, but the functionality is the same, so let's move on. All right, so for number three in this flags menu, do a search for a setting called Show Saved Copy Button. You can either search for it at the top or hit Control F and type it in there and it will find it. What this does is it will allow you to load a cached version of a website if it's available, if that website either fails to load or you're currently offline. So to enable it, go to the dropdown and select Primary as the option. That way, you can at least look at a previous version of the website even if it's not live, which might still be helpful. With this enabled, on the Fail to Load page, you'll see a new button to load the saved copy. If you're wondering what the secondary option means, it just changes whether the Load Copy button is on the left or the right, so it doesn't really matter. You can put it on the right if you want. Next, number four. This one is really great. It's called Parallel Downloading. So search for that one and turn it to enable. This will let Chrome use multiple download threads to speed up downloading of a file. This means if a website has a limit for how fast you can download a file, Chrome can basically download multiple parts of that file in parallel simultaneously, so you can cut the download speed to a fraction, or the download time rather. There's not really much documentation on this feature, so I'm not really sure how well it works or how often it does it, and if it does it every time, but I don't see a reason to not enable it unless you're having issues or something with it. By the way, there are extensions that can do this as well. I'm not gonna get into those because it's beyond the scope of this video, but you can look those up. Hopefully this feature will make those obsolete though and just work as well without any extensions. Moving on, number five, look for a setting called Smooth Scrolling, which is on by default. This is a personal preference, but I really hate smooth scrolling, so I disabled it. It just changes the way it feels to scroll on a page, and with smooth scrolling, it seems a lot slower and sluggish when scrolling. You can turn it on and off, and you can compare it yourself, but I find when smooth scrolling is disabled, scrolling with the mouse wheel just feels so much more responsive and instant, whereas there seems to be a bit of delay otherwise. And that's because to smooth out the scroll movement, it has to slowly build up the speed, then slow down to a halt. It's not something you would really notice unless you compare it for yourself, so try it out and see. Number 6, this one is really cool. Look for the setting called New Omnibox Answers in Suggestion Types and enable that. This makes it so you can type in questions or other queries into the Omnibox or the URL bar, and it can offer answers right there without having to do a search. For example, if I type in second president of the USA, it will give me the answer John Adams right in the autocomplete dropdown instead of having to do that search for it on Google. The only problem is it actually really sucks at working half the time, and you can type something in one time and it will answer it, and if you type it in again 2 seconds later, it won't. So it's definitely hit or miss, but I guess it's not bad to have enabled anyway. You can always just hit enter to do a Google search, which will show you the same information regardless. Okay, number 7, I really like this one, I think you should enable it. It also has to do with the Omnibox, and it's a setting called Omnibox UI Show Suggestion Favicons. What this does is when you type something into the URL bar and it lists those suggestions, it will now show the favicon or the site icon next to each result. So this is really great if you're searching for a website you visited previously and the results are from a bunch of different types of sites. You can now more quickly identify the results by scanning and looking at which icon for the site you're looking for. Plus, I think it just looks nicer because before it would just show little icons that didn't mean anything, and it was sometimes hard to sift through the results. So this is definitely one of my favorites, I'd even say. Number 8, this one is something you may or may not want to enable, called automatic tab discarding. What this will do is if you have a lot of Chrome tabs open and your computer starts to run slow on memory, it will stop running some tabs that you haven't been using. This way, those tabs are no longer using up the resources in the background, obviously. And if you do want to go back to each tab, Chrome will simply reload the page when you click on the tab again. So it doesn't close the tab, it just kind of deactivates them. The only downside I can see with this is if you have tabs running in the background that are actually doing something, I don't know, like a game or something, you don't necessarily want to close those because if you refresh, it will mess things up. So you can decide for yourself whether you want to enable this based on if your computer runs out of memory a lot or if you use a ton of tabs and what you actually have running in those tabs. On to number 9. This one is seriously one of my favorite features that as far as I know is not enabled by default for some reason, and it's called Tab Audio Muting UI Control. And this makes it really easy to mute annoying tabs that are playing sounds. When something is playing a sound in a tab, Chrome by default will tell you which tab it is by showing a little speaker icon. To mute that tab, you can normally right click on it and hit Mute Tab. But if you enable this feature, you can mute the tab simply by clicking on the little speaker icon right away. So sure, it saves you one click only, but it's so simple that it's a no-brainer. All right, coming near the end, got a couple more. Number 10 is called Fast Tab / Window Close. This is another one I like to have enabled. So normally when you go to close a tab, Chrome will stop any JavaScript applets running or anything else running, and once that's all stopped, it will only then actually close the tab. But sometimes that might take a second, which will seem like a delay when you're closing the tab, and can get annoying if you're closing a bunch of tabs at once. It seems like it'll take forever to do these. With this though, according to the limited documentation at least, Chrome will immediately close the tab visually and then shut down anything running from the tab in the background. I like this because if I close a tab, I just want it to disappear because it's taking up space on my screen. I don't care if Chrome has to take an extra second for it to close in the background, so this is nice. And finally, number 11. This feature is really amazing to enable. It's called Scroll Anchoring. Now, it does technically work on desktop, I guess, but if you're on Android, you can also enable this, and that is where it really shines. Basically, Scroll Anchoring can help prevent the page from jumping whenever you go on a site and it keeps loading new stuff after you've gone onto it. For example, how many times have you gone to a site and you start reading it on your phone and the stupid freaking ads start loading and pushing everything out of the way so you can't read? It's so obnoxious. When scroll anchoring is working, you won't actually notice because it simply stops the page from doing that. It keeps you in the same spot when it does work. It might not work all the time, it's a relatively new feature, but it's still better. But over time, you will start to take note that it happens less and less often. And I guess it does happen on desktop every once in a while, just less often, so it's still worth it to keep enabled on there. So that's everything. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you want to keep watching, I'll put some other videos right here you can watch. And on my channel, I've got a bunch of other Chrome-related videos you can check out. Be sure to let me know in the comments if I maybe missed something. And if you want to subscribe, I make new videos every Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday. And again, consider enabling notifications by clicking that bell. Looking forward to hearing from you guys. So thanks so much for watching. I'll see you next time. Have a good one.